Patrick Bros, senior expert on API and data modeling design at Amadeus. His topic is, what are smart APIs? How to apply them in travel, insurance, and banking? Hi, welcome, Patrick.
Thanks. I'm very happy to be the next speaker after Aslam about airport airlines. So today, in fact, I will speak about API, but not as a just transport data, but how an API could be smart. And then what after we see together, what are the definition of what is smart APIs, how to apply them to travel industry, to insurance, and banking or payment. So first of all, I would like to take inspiration about something that happened around to us about flip phone. So flip phone, are they data centric? Not really, just to exchange text or phone calls or voice call. Are they simple to use? Well, look about the keyboard, the screen and that kind of device, not super simple to use. Autonomous, but in fact, there is no big CPU, no big memory, nothing related to the some sensor to be connected and having some interactive, interactive application. Of course, there is some application in that kind of phone historically with, a calendar, calculator, but very limited. And what about the concept of to receive some notification or exchange, interact alert with the user? So, okay, this is basically a way to describe an anti-pattern of what is not smart. What is smart? It's not smart. So what is smart? What do we have something smart today? But in fact, we have what we call smart devices. So devices are, let's say, data-centric. So like your iPad, which is or your smartphone, your smartwatch, perhaps your smart car. So basically here, you see some device that help you to exchange some data, some event together, or even inside between application, you can exchange some data. And after that, what you like is really the concept of smart usage. And this is the scope of what is smart. So let's see together to take those six definitions of what is smart and how could you consider that now the next generation of API will be smart. So let's start to give a new name with that will be, let's say, the future of our API days. We'll speak now about smart APIs. So first of all, let's present myself. I'm Patrick Bros, working in Amadeus, and I am an expert on API design and data model. And my role is really here inside Amadeus as an API evangelist to help our API designer to design APIs for our product. And then to help them to say, okay, what are APIs becoming when you have a foundation which are now data-centric to become smart? So let's see together the API designer road trip for an API. So before to that, I will tell you the context of this presentation. I will use a real example that we did recently. And what are the challenges of an API designer? And the challenge of an API designer is to build, let's say, something elegant, future-proof, in a minimum of time. So let's see an example of an internal API that we design inside Amadeus during the pandemic. And I think it's a good illustration about something you know, and it was also related to the previous presentation, where we have to provide a safe travel application to help our customers, so airline or travel agency, to speed up, or let's say to secure the access of the airport, but be at home. So basically on the website, to verify that you have all the documents, all your health documents valid to enter the airport and then to do all the boarding pass and bag tag process that could be, let's say, of course, touchless or not. But if your documents are not valid, you don't need to move to go to the airport. You will be, let's say, rejected. So to put this in this context, we created the widget, which is available on the website of the company to verify that all your documents are valid before to come. So this is basically the context that I will explain how this application has been built. And I will show you the API designer journey to build a smart API and how the concept of smart API help us to design quickly an API. So basically the scope is really to this self-travel widget, where in fact it will be connected to a backend and to do some health documentation verification for the trip. So a smart device is something that we see. It should be data-centric. It should be simple to use, having a kind of autonomy, to be connected, interactive, and potentially able to send and receive notification. So what is the definition that could be applied to a smart API? But in fact, if you do the parallel, an API should be resource-oriented, having a concept of state, having a concept of controllers, hypermedia, some webhook, and event-driven. So when you speak about hypermedia, remember the Richardson maturity model. The level three is when you start to use hypermedia. So let's see together those definitions one by one and how it has been implemented in the scope of safe travel. So first of all, what is resource-oriented? So let me explain you in few seconds what is the concept of resource-oriented. And in fact, it's basically quite easy for us to explain when you are a developer. Historically, this mindset has been changed by developer 20 years ago. So basically, when you go from procedural programmation to object-oriented. But in fact, the new mindset for API is exactly the same. Historically, we were more SOAP-oriented with a procedural approach, where basically you have the functionality which is described by a verb, and potentially the data that you manipulate. Of course, some data will be part of the parameter. But when you are object-oriented, what you do, you first focus on the object, and you describe your object. So you put a context, and it starts to be very, very interesting because you have the context where you work, and then you can apply some functionality on top. So this is something which is having a kind of autonomy. And it would be a kind of the mother of design of any, let's say, new generation of API. Even if you speak about RedJSON, GraphQL, Async API, OpenAPI, the concept of to model your data is ultra important. So next step. So this is the baseline, resource-oriented. We are data-centric. So in fact, when you speak about data, what is interesting is the fact to have a state. And this is also the foundation of REST, is how to explain the state. And what is the value of the state? The state is basically all of you to show you that you have something which is static and become dynamic. And this is basically the definition of a representation of state transfer in REST. And how could we use that during the verification of your health document with the safe travel widget? So in fact, you consider that you have a resource, which is a third-party verification having an ID and a status. Okay, this is a resource. It's kind of job to help you to do a verification. And why a third party is because, in fact, inside Amadeus, we have no certification to verify directly the document itself. So basically, we delegate the verification to someone to a third party, which is Evernime. And in fact, in your API, we create a post API to create this verification process attached to some health document related to a traveler. So this is, you see, in the past, you start to see, let's say, the hierarchy and the semantic of the context. And basically, the API will help you to launch a process to verify the health document. So we delegate the process to a third-party API. And basically, the state of our process is ongoing. Of course, there is some, let's say, interaction with the user, perhaps to scan some QR code, to upload document, and so on. So basically, you have a process which is ongoing. And what you expect at the end is to have something which is validated. So basically, when you check the state of the verification process, at the end, you can see that it is verified or not. So the status of your resource helps you to simulate this concept of state. So now, basically, it's very simple. You have a resource and you can visualize it and you know where you are. And we started with the concept of job, and this is one of the most advanced concepts that we created inside Amadeus. Is, of course, when you speak about REST and REST API, people are speaking about, okay, you have to manipulate a resource. Okay, so a resource could be a health document, a COVID-19 area report, or a health pass. But in fact, okay, you have what we call CRUD operation, like a create, read, update, delete. So you can manipulate those resources. But at the end, how to handle such complex processes, which are the verification, okay? In fact, what we did, we invented the concept of controller. And the controller is here to manipulate your resource in very clear windows. And you have the scope, which is very clear. It's you do a verification. And you don't do something else. And this verification is becoming a job attached to your resource, and it could be considered as a sub-resource. So the concept of controller is here really to enrich as a satellite your resource with plenty of pseudo API related to your microservices. So basically, you see the new generation of API which have some microservice attached to the resource. So here you have a kind of autonomy because you can add plenty of controller around your resource. Remember, I started to speak about hypermedia. Hypermedia is, let's say, the most advanced concept in a Richardson maturity model, where you can provide some links between resources. And this is exactly what is a web. When you look about the web is working alone, and you have, let's say, a link between pages or between forms to help you to discover what are the next steps. But in fact, you can follow this process and do the same with APIs. How? So let's imagine that you have to upload some document to be verified during your health verification. So basically, you provide your health document, but in fact, in some countries, some area, you have to upload some other document to justify your identity, to provide a COVID-19 test in the same time. So basically, you start a process, but the process is stopped and it's still ongoing, and you need to do something else. And how to provide a link to say, okay, now I need to upload some other documents. So you have an array of documents attached to the verification process. And then you can have a status of your process saying, okay, hey guys, you have some missing document. And then those documents should be, let's say, uploaded. And please upload a document having a validity of less than 72 hours. So you see, you can, with the concept of hyper schema, which is the most advanced concept in a JSON schema organization, where you associate to your resource some link with other APIs. And this is really a way to do a next step, saying to the user, hey guys, you start a verification process related to your travel, you give me your health document, but I need to attach some other document. So please use upload those documents via these APIs. So the UI can interact with the user, and which is really the concept of HOS, where you have the, let's say, hypertext engine state to manipulate and the relationship between several resources to help the user to discover, let's say, the flow or the process. So here we have the concept of hyperschema, and if you look about the Open API, you have also now the concept of webhook. So what is the concept of webhook? You remember when we started the verification, we delegate this verification to a third party, which is Evernime, and we receive OK. But it is asynchrone. So the concept is, OK, how to receive, let's say, a OK, which on something that has been started. And this is nice because you have a concept of webhook, and then we have the opportunity to define to Evernime a specific dynamically a specific endpoint where they can send us the update to the verification. So basically, we subscribe to them to receive some event on our system. So basically, we define some endpoint that we call a traveler health document third party verification /ID/Evernime event. So basically, for this particular verification process, they are able to come and to give us some update on the process of the verification. And potentially here, you can, in the UI, you can implement a kind of progress bar depending of the state that you receive. And this is super nice for the user to understand where you are in your process. So this is the concept of webhook, where you define a dedicated endpoint related to a specific resource. And we can imagine that this one is more a fictive approach where you can combine the concept of Open API with asynchronous API. So imagine that you have, and it's something that we have also inside Amadeus, another API, which is now this one public, which is Duty of Care. And thanks to our partner Riskline, where in fact we have a collaboration with them to produce some COVID-19 area report. When you say area, it could be a country, city, or region. And the idea is, potentially to imagine the future that this the condition of a specific country or specific region will evolve during the time, and how it could be automatically updated about that kind of evolution. Potentially, you can imagine to have a specific controller that we call monitors. So basically, you can monitor a specific resource. So you can let any user to subscribe to this resource for a specific country to monitor the evolution. And potentially, depending of the subscription state, you will receive email or SMS or potentially, let's say, alert in your application. So this is basically the ultimate vision of APIs or smart APIs when you combine event-driven architecture and query reply via open APIs. So this is what is the context to explain you, let's say, what is smart and how it has been applied to APIs. And now my question is, okay, how to apply, we apply that to travel, but all of those concepts, this journey, how it could be applied to payment or insurance industry. So let's have a look a little specific path to explain you. And here I will explain you something that I started to show you just before, but more in detail, how to put in place a concept of asynchronous controller. So asynchronous controller is basically that you don't have an answer yet of something. So let's imagine that you have a travel order, which is the business of Amadeus to create some travel reservation, and you want to have a specific offer to an insurance, and you basically would like to buy an insurance associated to your travel. And during this process of travel order, you, at one period of time, you need to pay to continue the flow. And during the payment process, you will start to create an authorization, okay? Imagine you have a 3D secure, so you have to enter a code or let's say a validation of your mobile to validate the payment. So basically you start to have an asynchronous process. So you can imagine that the first step of the payment record, so basically you will create a new resource during the authorization. And during this authorization, a new resource will be attached, a sub-resource will be attached to your travel order. And this resource, which is called payment record, will be created, but the state is still ongoing because you need to interact with as a 3D secure to enter some information about the authorization, and of course there is some delay. So basically, this record, which is attached to your travel order, will help you to keep the visibility where you are in the process of the payment. And typically, you can visualize this record. And thanks to HTTP status, thanks to the e-tag, you can step by step visualize the state of this resource, and potentially this resource has not yet modified. And at one period of time, you consider that, in fact, the change of this state has been now okay. So basically, it's a kind of summary about what we see just before, where you combine everything, the state, the concept of controller, and the concept of relationship between resources. So this is the ultimate way to implement the concept of a smart API during the insurance or payment industry. So this is the vision where we are now in API. It's no more to convey data. It's now where you can basically help the user thanks to the REST approach to document and to provide some free review flow. So to summarize quickly before the question, I know that you are arriving to the questions. So basically, the concept, the secret of the design smart API are really that. The modularity and to be data-centric, to follow the state representation, to be autonomous with controllers, to be connected with hypermedia and hyperschema, to have the concept of webhook to receive some interaction of event, and of course, the ultimate things will be to associate open API to async API. So I'm very happy to have presented this use case during the pandemic, and it was very, very important for us to provide that kind of product, where we verify more than 15 million of documents in 1 year, and this is one of the success story that we can share with you. So, if you have questions, you are welcome.
Yeah. Yes, Patrick. There are some questions. So, In the both the previous speakers referred to Amadeus as the large GDS player, with a huge market share in the airline industry, right? So just wanted to know, GDS is Amadeus started as a GDS, and it's also an IT provider, IT solutions provider. But where is it headed? What is the next step for Amadeus?
Yes, of course, we are. It's true that historically we are seen as a GDS. But let's say we evolve during those 20 years, because APIs for us is part of our DNA. We build APIs in 25 years to be interconnected with airline, with airport, with a hotel provider, with the car rental system and cruise system. So this is, let's say, the kernel of Amadeus was a GDS. But in fact, we diversified, and now we are IT providers for airlines, for airports. And what could be the next step? This is a good question. The idea is to become an open platform. So thanks to those concepts of API, Amadeus will be a more technical hub for the travel industry. And we see that with the pandemic, where we have to learn some new concepts, like the health industry. Potentially, you know the concept of travel identification. Traveler identification, sorry, to speed up the traveler experience. So yes, the next step are really to focus on the traveler experience and to become an open platform to let our partners to bring more data or more functionality themselves on our system.
Okay, yeah, sure. So the next one. So how do you see the API design in the future? What is it going to be?
The concept of SOAP with a function was, the vision in the past. Now, for sure, REST API is clearly the new baseline. It's a new mother for me. It's a new mother of APIs. So for us, we have to be REST-oriented. Why? Because we'll become data-centric. Now, everything will be related to the data. And to create the glue between the developers, the business people, analytics, machine learning, everything will be related to the data before the functionality. So yes, for me, the API design will become, let's say, very data-centric, and potentially the next challenge, it's something that we see to work more agile and so on, in a minimum of time, is to provide on the platform all the tools to follow the principle of API design first. So the idea is to really to design APIs before to code, and maybe even to test them before to code. And this could be very powerful, because imagine you have several partners to work with. You provide the API contract, you provide the concept of mock-up server, they can play, they can give you some feedback of the APIs, and you have even not started to code. So basically, your code will be really aligned to the final requirement to discover the requirement. If you want, I can provide you a link about a talk that I did during a Microsoft build, where I explained how Amadeus started to first API to API first to API to first API to API first.
Okay. Yeah. Sure. So that will be good addition to the deck as an information source. Yeah, great. Thank you, Patrick. Appreciate that, and thanks a lot for joining us here at API Days Dubai and Middle East, and sharing your views on about the smart APIs. Thanks a lot.
It's always a pleasure. Thank you. Thanks for your attention and your invitation. I appreciate it.